I'm sure we'll get one of these little... Oh, we're seen. Spirit of Ad Nua? The shade emerges like a wound in the world, split open to reveal a hollow darkness. Beneath a writhing crown of shadow lies a gleaming mask bearing the visage of an older man. The silver face turns towards you, features cold and still. From within the sockets of the mask's eyes, guttering fires emit their eerie light.
Who are you? Would you abandon your king? Take up your sword! To battle! The enemy has come!
His voice seems to reverberate through the chamber. I think it is reverberating throughout the chamber. The mask's eyes burn with sudden new light, even as the room around you seems to grow darker. I don't want to refer to it as a spirit. Sometimes they get angry. Up the stairs. I'm not sure what king he's referring to, if he's referring to Ad Nua as the king. I am Theodas. I have come in search of the master below.
Then you are no lost soul of mine. No soldier. I have no power over you.
Well, I'm glad for that.
But neither have you found your quarry, for before you is Ad Nua, king in life of a great people. Master now of nothing.
Okay, so this is literally the spirit of Ad Nua. Okay, I was just taking it as a spirit of Ad Nua is in this place. You built the endless paths.
The endless paths. A thousand hands toiled to create it. But it was my voice. My will that directed them. The great work of our age.
Of course, I am really wondering who is in charge. Or it would have been, I was waiting for the voice, if they had only allowed me to finish, if they understood that from such rotted foundations could emerge wondrous achievement, that the same curse I sought to cure afflicted them in turn. That my son might, from one moment to the next, be lost to me is abomination. His voice thickens with grief, reverberating throughout the chamber. He wants only that I should be proud of him. How can a father convince his son that he might accomplish nothing and still be the light of his life? How, if he is gone? So many hours and days spent wondering, if I had only been there but a moment earlier, if I had stopped him from leaving that morning, if I had only known that I would never see him again.
Lost. Treading these endless paths. These regrets. With him forever moving out of reach. Into some darker place. Away from me. Have they loved nothing in all their lives? Lost nothing! Wives! Husbands! Children! Might I not show them, then, the agony of it?
Ad Nua's shade shudders, and the very shape of him seems to warp and twist. The tines of his dark crown grow long, and the surface of his mask ripples like molten metal. What has caused the past to become overrun? It takes Ad Nua a moment to speak. Time. The press of time. We chased such beasts from our work sites in our day. They were but passing pests, but in time their numbers have been allowed to grow. And now they are chased up from the depths by that which dwells there. The new master of this place, feeding on the souls of all that have succumbed to the paths. To grief or greed.
Have they loved nothing in all their lives.
Sadness.
Lost nothing. Wives, husbands, children. Might I not show them then the agony of it?
That's odd they repeated that. What happened to this place? Adnua's voice gains a distant quality. We sought the place where the veins of the world meet, where a soul might be drawn from the Adra. If we could find the means to keep the soul intact, to preserve its memory, we are so close. It is nearly done. My people shaped for me a titan, vast and wondrous in form, so that it might be worthy of the soul that would dwell within it. He reaches out a hand, pointing a dark and tapering claw towards the steps. I have not looked upon it since. They will destroy all that I have worked for. They will steal my only hope. Adnua raises his arms, now lashing tendrils of shadow. Will we allow the rabble to strike us from this world? To steal my son from me a final time?
Up, soldiers! Up, conquerors of death! Keep them from the statue! Will you leave your lord to fight alone?
The stone seems to shake beneath your feet, and the air grows cold, but nothing emerges from the darkness. The echoes of Adnua's command fade. His spirit regards the crystal where his body dwells, silent. How are you still here? Is it so strange? I can see, sense the power in you. You must have seen, by now, the limits of the shroud. How easily one slips its shackles, if pressed. My son did not have the time, perhaps, to. It was so fast. His soul went swiftly into the stream. But I could find it again. I did find it. I was so close. And then the invaders, the mutiny, traitors, all, coming to smash the machines, the crystals. They had no thought for the lives spent, the progress we had made. To rip a soul from the afterlife? To return him to my arms? I was so close. Huh. I'm beginning to think he really made all this just to get his son back. The mob slew my most faithful. Then came for me, a blade in the stomach, like any common dog. But I robbed them of their trophy. My body, at least, would not be parted from this place. I cast one final spell. He indicates the crystal at the center of the room, and gazes upon it for a few moments. And what happened? There was pain. I woke some time later. Woke, or else just became aware that I was in the world again. That I had sight, and hearing, and memory. Always memory. This chamber I recall, the final moments, and in recalling them I am returned to my power. It is tempting sometimes to remain thus, to be some semblance of a king. If not that I remember all else, too, the hurt of dying, the loss, I feel as keenly on the day my son was taken from me. Such things, too, not be claimed by time? As our words, our art, and lives have been, is the memory so cruel that time dares not touch it? For 2,000 years I have stood upon the precipice of victory. I cannot retreat nor cross. I am anchored to the very stone I shaped to shield my corpse, and all the while he is there, just out of reach, beyond me. Before you is Adnua, king in life of a great people, in death, master of nothing. Why have you sent beasts to attack me? What are you, that I should concern myself with your life, when they have trapped me here? I cannot cross the threshold. The way is barred to me. He is out of my reach even now. They have broken it, my statue, my memorial. The vein is severed, and I am parted from the source. And still something dwells in the place beneath us, and there feeds upon my people, as it did when we drew breath. An old, ancient thing. You will not conquer it, any more than we could conquer ignorance.
None walk there save Ardnua's line. You will not tread in that place. Not there.
The mass turns towards you, streaks of golden fire running from its eyes. What's down there? All the souls the paths have ever known, bound still to the Adra, waiting for their chance at rebirth, or else trapped within the fragments. He reaches a formless hand towards his mask, only to jerk it away as if scalded. My son, somewhere. He must be. If you are not master in this place, who is? Something with a longer reach, for I can do nothing outside this wretched chamber. The stone is like an anchor. The mask turns back to the crystal at the center of the room, and the body there.
Many souls do pass, from time to time, into this place. The Adra draws them deep, and there they are consumed, but not by me.
Something dwells in this place beneath us, and there feeds upon my people, as it did when we drew breath. It is an old, ancient thing, and you will not conquer it any more than we could conquer ignorance. And I'll repeat. Adnur suddenly shudders, and the shape of him seems to warp and twist. The tines of his dark crown grow long, and the surface of his mask ripples like molten ore.
None walk there save Adnur's line. You will not tread in that place. Not there.
If this thing is responsible for the attacks on Cadnua, then perhaps I can help us both. How? Will you destroy that which survived the end of my people? No. You will only anger it. It will drink your life like water. Huh. But it's destroying this place, as surely as the Ingwithins did. It threatens your world, your homes. Not mine, for we are long dead. To me, it is but an obstacle. And when it, too, at last perishes, I will have my chance. I have waited for so long. I cannot risk this.
But you see them. What remains of them? As the Mad One did before you. As I do. My subjects. My people. Many souls. None walk there save Adnua's line. You will not tread in that place. Not there.
Be calm. I mean you no harm. You can do nothing I would not suffer gladly to keep you from that place. Do you think to fool me? We have suffered too many traitors. Adnua raises a hand towards his face, and the fires there dim. You would only be destroyed, as swiftly as any other soul which ventures there. I cannot risk that you should meddle with the statue. No, I will not allow it.
But you see them. What remains of them? As the Mad One did before you. As I do. My subjects. My people.
Okay, how do we escape from this dialogue without attacking him? You sealed yourself in here? Nothing so precise. I meant only to die in some manner that hindered them. It was not pleasant. If I had time to think. I did not imagine that I would be trapped. What force could hold me? Yet every effort I expend to leave this place, there are times I can sense what lies above, but never below. Your people wanted vengeance for what you did to them.
Vengeance? And what of my vengeance? A son, taken from me in prime of life. My boy, not of illness, nor of age, not well. Do you understand? His soul lingered yet in the living world. I knew it. I sensed it. But I could not speak to him. Could not hear him.
You could have. I sense it on you. The spirit's voice is ragged, but we are 2,000 years too late. How I remember him still. His face. I need no carving to remind me. He was much like his mother. Wanted to be a warrior as she was, but had my temper, my wretched looks. He brings up his fists, wreathed in wisps of shadow. I would have slaughtered the world to have him return to me. They ought to have been honored to sacrifice their lives for his resurrection, to save their prince.
None walk there save all.
I don't really want to attack him. Do I have a choice?
Have they loved nothing in all their lives? Lost nothing? Wives, husbands, children? Might I not show them then the agony of it?
I understand your grief, but why all this? It did not start so. How could it? I was mad with grief. I summoned workers, mages, servants. We plunged headlong into our quest. I could not see for tears. And at first nothing. Feeble efforts, false starts, days of nothing. And all the while I was certain I was losing time. I gave permission that we should try new methods, that we should bolster our knowledge of the soul. And with these barbarous acts we began at last to learn, to find the edges of that veil. My people told me they could find my son, but still we had not the means of extracting him, safe, intact. And at last, when a discovery was at hand, we were betrayed. All that we had paid, the lives lost, the taint upon our souls, all for nothing. They destroyed the Titan, cleaved him from his roots.
I will never see him again. Even in death, we have been more wholly separated than if I had never known him. He will have forgotten me. Have I not paid? Have they not cost me all I had?
One and two. Perhaps your son's spirit still remains here somewhere. You think the possibilities not rule my thoughts? I have been bound, as surely as they had intended it. It is an irony I have reflected upon for longer than you have walked the world, and now you think to counsel me? Ooh, excellent. It is not the chamber binding you, it is your rage, your grief. That is, no. I have tried to leave this place. I would go to my son. I would let nothing stop me. You are lying. The shade's eyes glow with an ominous light. The souls here, they're all trapped within a moment. They cannot free themselves. It is the same with you.
No! It is not my doing. It cannot be so simple. I will drive the invaders from the halls. I will go down those final steps, and there, finish my great work. None will stop me.
Look around you. There are no invaders. Adnua turns regarding the room, and then his fiery gaze settles back upon you. A blue fire sparks behind Adnua's mask, casting a sickly light across the tiles. No. No, you will go from here and bring them with you. Bring the mob again, with blade and fire. They will destroy all that I have worked for. They will steal my only hope. Adnua raises his arms, now lashing tendrils of shadow. Will we allow the rabble to strike us from this world? To steal my son from me a final time? Up, soldiers! Up, conquerors of death! Children of the Wheel, Andara, Riamara, Isarna, keep her from the statue. I don't want the statue. Oh boy. Alright. Greater Windblight, Spirit, Riamara, named Shenguela things. Alright. Okay. At least Alas is back here where he's supposed to be. Boom. Disintegrate. I can't cast that yet. Now we can go.
This?
Oh, wow. Cast it here. Have her use, Lay on Hands, I guess. Or she's paralyzed. Well. Suppress Affliction, then. So I guess she's casting it now. Is she still paralyzed? Oh no! He's weakened. Must heal. She still has yet to cast it. She's paralyzed again. Oh, this is getting a problem. There's a big problem here. He's paralyzed. She's paralyzed. Okay, we're gonna die. Akana's down already. Okay. Where is this guy? Old guy. Aeloth, Kanna, Dare, Theodas. Oh, Durance is in the middle of all this crap. He's paralyzed now? Oh, he's probably just gonna die then. She still hasn't cast Lay on Hands on herself. Oh, and Kanna's back somehow. Where is Kanna? Here, okay.
Hey.
Durance is out. Mirrored image. I guess on him, I don't know. Is she finally casting her spell? My god. This will be end badly. She should bring him back. She's stunned, though. I got a break around here. Is he... Okay, he's back. Okay, begin healing people. That would be a good thing to do. Theodas and, Kana. Aeloth is down. This is Theodas. Where's Kana? Boom. Cast it already? If you didn't cast it already, cast it now. Theodas. Kana. Cast the sucker. One more time. Then I'll try to bring Aeloth back. She's paralyzed. Dare, Kana. Suppress affliction. All right, one's down. Paralyzed. Stunned. Is she still paralyzed? Flanked, zealous, weakened, stunned. She's stunned, terrified, paralyzed. Oh god, everything! Lay on hands.
Please help!
We'd love to help you. Excuse me.
This isn't working!
He still hasn't cast us. Hurry up, cast it. Never mind it then. Well, you can't stop. Ah, Theodas is down. Too late.
Sail me.
Finish your spell.
Maybe.
Finish your spell. Thank you. What do I have? Can he bring someone back? What does it look like? Kind of a fist? No. Interdiction. Oh, are you attacking? Please attack. Immune? just... These guys are out. Who is this standing here?
What?
I'm trying here. We are still attacking it, right? Making sure we're, like, doing stuff here. I can't switch people? What the hell? Okay, there he is. I don't have it clear out? Oh, it's per rest? Oh, crap. I thought it was per encounter. We got this stupid thing. Can we finish it? Kill it.
I'm soon for the...
It killed him. Alright, whoever's left, attack. You have no lay on hands left. Yeah, unbending. Can I use that?
I'm ready.
Can I keep using it? You are attacking him, right? One more cannon. Yay! Wow. We barely won that one. Yeah, we could have approached the attack a little smarter. I figured we'd just talk him out of it. Oh well. We couldn't. Primal Wind. Ooh, a Shroud of Mourning. +3 resolve. +3 damage reduction from corrode and freeze. The rough texture and faded color of this cloak suggests that it is ancient. The symbols and runes along the edges indicate Ingwithin origins. Scholars of Ingwithin culture have translated an old story about a father driven mad with grief by the death of his son. He entered a permanent state of mourning, donning the traditional garb of the bereaved and locking himself in his keep. The story suggests that he performed horrific experiments upon the living in an effort to resurrect his dead son. His mourning clothes were said to be infused with power as a result of these experiments. Huh. Well, I wonder who that might be about. Now, this is only resolve, and it's got stuff. Everything?
Sure.
Wow, guys. Well, stay tuned for next episode when we advance down to level 14 of the Endless Paths of Adnua. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.